Hi guys! I was watching a video about what is art, and the concept of color choice came up. My former stepfather liked to tell a story that I was interviewed by some art magazine, and the guy asked me how I choose my colors, and my answer was, that's what I have in my box. This interview never happened, but having watched that video and thinking about that story, I got the idea to tell you how I really choose my colors. I've already talked about the importance of using a lot of color to create depth, and specifically of the role of color in creating fur, and I'll put cards for both of these up somewhere. Now I'm going to get into the ways that I choose my colors. The first and most common way that I choose colors is just by what I see. Look at my reference photo, see what colors are there, and try to choose or mix something as close to it as I can. The second way is by what I personally like. Like I said, I usually follow my reference photo, but if I feel like it, I will take some artistic liberties with the color. As long as it could still be believable, that is. For example, I probably never paint a blue dog, unless I just wanted to get crazy. But if someone was wearing, say, a cobalt blue shirt, I might paint it cerulean if I felt like it. Color really isn't the most important thing when it comes to making something look realistic. Value is. And if you're doing a commission, you obviously can't take as many liberties with the color as you could if you were doing your own piece, because obviously you have to please the client, and especially if it's a pet or something, or someone's giving you a picture of them, they probably expect you to use the colors that are in the picture. The third way that I choose colors is what will look best for the painting. Sometimes I'll purposely change a color that's in the reference photo simply because the color that's in the photo wouldn't work for the painting. Example is this portrait of Shanti from 2015. In my reference photo, this hat is more of like a deep maroon color, but that would have blended in too much with the background, as you can see from the color I chose. So I painted the hat a brighter red instead. When doing portraits, I try to choose a background that will make the subject stand out, which is why I tend to favor either black or colored backgrounds for portraits rather than beige or brown backgrounds, because that would blend into most people's skin color too much. When I was working on this portrait of Kit Medina, for example, I thought he looked like a ghost. He was just blending in so much with the background, and I realized I was going to have to amp up the rosiness in his skin if I was going to make him look like a living, breathing person and not just part of the wall. The last and least common way that I choose colors is symbolism and meaning. I use this method in my painting Woman with Cabinet. This painting was inspired by the lyrics to the song Killer Queen written by Freddie Mercury. I read that Freddie had said in an interview that the song was about a high-class call girl. So my goal was to depict a regal whore, basically. So I chose red as the background because red represents passion and lust and love, and even for many years was the official color of prostitutes. And I painted the dark blue mattress and the dark purple sheet because those colors, the dark blue and the purple, are colors of royalty. So those are how I choose colors. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe for videos Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and for live streams Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. I'll see you again tomorrow with another live stream. Goodbye!